A very good afternoon, dear students. I hope you all are safe at your place. I, Professor Sonal Agrawal, welcome you all on the digital platform of Agrawal Vidya Vihar English Medium College. This is a lecture for the subject Human Resource Management. What we did in the last lecture, I just want to brief out in short that in the last lecture, we have completed the process of human resource planning. Here, now today we are going to start with the new topic, that is the job analysis. You may heard about this word or you may not be aware about this word, that what is meaning by job analysis. So first of all, let me clear that the meaning of job. What do you mean by job? Then after we are going to discuss about the job analysis. So in the simple word, when the total work that could be done is divided and the group into the package, that is known as a job. Here again I am repeating, when the total work that going to be done by the human resource is divided and grouped in some of the packages, that packages are known as the job. Now the question arises that what do you mean by job analysis? You are very much familiar with the word analysis here, and we just discussed the meaning of the job. So job plus analysis. So what do you mean by job analysis then? Job analysis is a process of studying and collecting the information relating to the operations and responsibilities of a specific job. This definition is according to the book of K. Ashwat Thapa. Again, I am repeating, job analysis is the process of studying and collecting the information relating to the operating, or the, you can say, the operations and the responsibility of a specific job. Here, or you can take here the example of any job that is related to the organization. Suppose the job of a salesman, the job of a manager, the job of a peon, you can say. So which types of qualities the person requires, which types of what is the person has to do here, actually what the person is going to be do, what the procedure he is going to be take. This basically based on the four questions. That first question is, what does the employee do here, employee maybe for any post? And second question is, how does he do, he or she? And the third question is, why does he do? And the fourth question is, what types of skills are required for performing that functions or for performing that job? If a person is able to answer these four questions, so it is known as the job analysis. I'm referring again that the first question is, what does the employee do? The second question is, how does he do? The third question is, why does he do? And the fourth question is, what type of skills that are required for the performance of that duties? These four, the answer of this four question is known as the job analysis. In short, you can say that the right person for the right job at the right time and in a right place is known as the job analysis. If you have done the job analysis, then only you are able to appoint the right person at the right job in a right time or at the right place. Here, the job analysis is the base for these functions. Again, I am repeating, if any analysis is able related to the job, if any analysis related to the job is able to answer these four questions, then that analysis is known as the job analysis. First question is, what does the employee do? The second question is, how does he do? The third question is, why does he do? And the last question is, which types of skills are required to do so? This is known as the job analysis. I have mentioned here so many definitions related to the job analysis according to the many person or many specialists, you can say. So you can learn any two definition, any two good definition according to you, which seems to be easy for you as, to learn this definition. So you can choose any two definition out of these definitions. And another, so many definitions are available in the different books, so you can learn the any two definitions of the job analysis. Here, you just can take the screenshot of this and you can learn the definitions. The second is, before starting about it, I just want to say that the job analysis is the process by which the data regarding each of the jobs is systematically collected and noted by making the detailed study of each of the component part of the job. It provides the detailed information about the nature of the job, authority, responsibility, which are connected with the particular job, and the qualities and the qualifications which required in the job. So the performance must be satisfactory for a particular job. Yeah, whatever we just discussed. that what the person requires, which types of question is going to be asked, that these four questions, what does the employee do, how to do, why to do, and which types of skills are required. So the answer of this all thing is known as the job analysis. Just I say again, I'm repeating again for you, if you missed it out, that job analysis is a process by which the data regarding each of the job is systematically collected and noted by making detailed study of each of the components of the job. It provides the detailed information about the nature of the job, authority and responsibility collected with the job, and the qualities and the qualifications which require for the satisfactory performance for the job. Here, so this is known as a job analysis. From the job analysis, we can get two types of information. The information is pertaining to the job itself, like nature of the job and the responsibilities which are connected with it, and how it is going to be performed, what types of tools are used, etc. And secondly, what type of information is going to be collected, that the second information is about the qualities and the qualifications that desirable in the job for the satisfactory performance of the job. So here, two things are very, very important. So these two things are bifurcated, or you can say that these two things are the components of the job analysis. The name of these two things are known as the job description and job specification. Whatever I just said, so these two things are in a single word, you can say it is job description and job specification. Again, for the better understanding level of you, I have mentioned here the meaning of job specification and the job description, that a written summary of the task, duties and responsibility of a job is known as the job specification. Just whatever I said, that nature of the job and the responsibilities which are connected with it and what the person has to do, these all things are known as the job specification. The second one is about the job description, that minimal skills, educations, experience and which are necessary for the performance, or for the satisfactory performance of the job is known as the job description. Here, the job analysis means job specification plus the job description. If any analysis is able to answer these two questions, so that analysis is known as the job analysis. I hope it is very, very clear. Try to make the meaning very clear. Again, I am repeating, if the meaning is clear, then only you are able to understand the other content or the other points in a better way. If meaning is not so much clear, then you will find a little bit difficult to understand the other topics, like the objectives and like the importance of the job analysis. So if the meaning is very clear, then the other things will be very easy for you. So try to make the meaning very, very clear. What do you mean by job analysis? So what we did till now, we have discussed the meaning of job, that the total work which are bifurcated or which are grouped into the packages, that work is known as the job. Clear? And for the performance of the job, the person who is the HR manager of the organization has to do some of the analysis. So here the question arises, that what do you mean by job analysis? So job analysis is a process by which the HR manager can appoint the right person for the right job at the right time, at the right place. Here, so what is ultimately going to be done in the job analysis? So in the job analysis, the HR manager is able to answer these two questions. Here, first question is about the task, duties and responsibility that a person has to perform in job. Here, that what the person has to do, what is the duty of that person and what are the responsibility of that person in the job. So this question is known as the job specification. The second question the HR manager is able to answer is about the description, that which types of skills or education or experience required for the satisfactory performance of that job. So these all things is known as the job descriptions. So job specification plus the job description is known as the job analysis. Here, suppose the HR manager is doing the job analysis for the work of peon. So here, what the peon has to do here daily, which types of performance the peon has to do, and second, which types of skills he require, what is there must be requirement of any experience or not, what may be the basic qualifications, he may be this you can say educated person or he may not be educated person, but the experience is very much required. So these types of questions may arise for the selection of the person for any post here, whether it is the middle level post, high level post or the bottom level post. Here, this types of question is very, very IMP for selecting a person. So if the analysis related to any job, related to any post, is able to answer answer this, all the questions. So that analysis is known as the job analysis. I hope it is clear to you. For the better understanding, I have mentioned here a chart that what is the job description and what is the job specification. So job descriptions means the job title, working hours, duties and responsibilities that the person has to do, working condition in what types of working condition the person has to perform, that if it is given, so what is the position, at what place he is going to perform the duties, at which types of working condition he has to perform his duties, what are the salaries, grades and what are the incentives that he is going to receive. This, the answer of this, all the things is known as the job description. Job title means what the title of that post, like peon, manager, and he may be the worker, what the title he is going to get out of the job, that is known as the job title. Working hours, for what the working hours, for how many working hours the person has to work in the organization. So if any analysis is able to answer this all the questions, so it is known as the job descriptions. Now the second one is the job specification, that for performing the job description, for performing this all the functions, which types of qualification must the person having, and which types of quality he must be having, whether the experience required for the particular post or not, what must be the family background of that person, and whether the person required to go through any training procedure or after selecting the person or not. So if any analysis is able to answer this all the questions, so it is known as the job specification. So ultimately, job analysis means job descriptions plus the job specifications. I hope it is very, very clear to you. You can also say that the job description is the quantitative data and the job specification are the qualitative data. Now today we are going to discuss about the uses, or you can say the importance of the job analysis, that for what purpose the analysis of the job analysis is essential for an organization. So we are going to discuss about the points one by one in detail. So the first point is about the useful for the recruitment and the selection. Here, for scientific recruitment, what do you mean by scientific recruitment? Just we discussed that the right person at the right place, at the right time, at the right at the right time and at the right place. So these all the things are known as scientific recruitment. That the scientific recruitment and the selection procedure, if we want to do in our organization, so we should have the knowledge of the job requirements. The job requirements refers to the natural qualities and the qualifications that is essential for performing any post in a satisfactory way. Clear? So job requirements can be prescribed on the basis of job descriptions and the job job descriptions and the job analysis, that what we just discussed now. And the job description is prepared from the job analysis. Therefore, the job analysis, you can say that it is useful for determining the job requirements, which are useful for selecting a right man for a particular job. Yeah, if you want to recruit any right person at a right place, so it is the basic requirement that you have done for the job analysis for the organization. The second person, helpful in planning the transfer and promotion. If you are planning the transfer of any employee in your organization, and if you want to promote the employee in your organization, so the planning in the career path, planning related to the career path of your employees working in your organization is one of the functions that the human resource manager has to do. Here the career path refers to a chart, you can say, that showing the transfer and the promotion between the different posts. Here, job analysis is useful in planning such types of career path, because by planning career paths, like here we are talking about the transfer and promotion, here the job requirements are taken into the consideration. Here, once the planning paths are clear, then the decisions about the transfer and promotion will be very, very easy for the HR manager. So if the person is planning for the transfer and promotion of any employee, and the person is planning about the career path of the employee, so it is required that the job analysis must be done before it. The next one is about the helpful in planning the training. Now it is all about the training procedure, that selection of the one staff made on the basis of job requirement. Why? Because as we just discussed, that before selecting a person, the job requirement must be done. So it is possible that the selected person may not be satisfied all the job requirements, whatever the analysis in the job analysis method. So there must be a certain deficiencies here. So what are the requirements that deficiencies must be find out here between the qualities of the person and between the you consider whatever analysis done by you in the job analysis, and that deficiency can be find out to remove, so that you can remove that deficiency. And how to remove that deficiency? So of course, yes, you can remove the deficiency with the training program. Yeah, so you have to work out the training program. In this case, the job analysis is also helpful for the planning of training program. How it is helpful? That if you are if you have done the job analysis, then only you can compare the job analysis with the actual quality of the person. Yeah, so after that you can find out the deficiency and you can take the remedial measures. If you have if you didn't done the job analysis, then you are not able to find out the deficiencies, then you are not able to take the remedial actions. So of course it is not going to you can say the helpful for the organizations. The fourth point is about the useful in developing the new job methods. Here, if you want to develop any new job method in your organization, so with the help of the job analysis, the person, the HR manager, can find out the unnecessary motions, or that unnecessary motion can be removed in from the process, and ultimately the person is able to develop the new, or you can say the improved method for the performing of the job. Here. So this is done with the help of the job analysis. If you want to remove any unnecessary emotion, or you can say the method of performing the job, and if you want to start with the new method or develop any better method of the performing any job, here suppose your job for the example, just take the example of production. Here for the production process, you want to do the production process with the some new methods. Now what do you have to do? You have to find out that unnecessary method which is taking more time for the production process. So you are able to find out that unnecessary method with the help of the job analysis. And after finding that unnecessary method which is taking the more time for the production process, what you can do? You can start with the better production process. Yeah? But how to find out this unnecessary production process? With the help of the job analysis, of course. So if you want to develop any new job method, so ultimately the job analysis will be helpful for it. The next is helpful in providing the protections against the accidents. Here, yes, of course, by the job analysis that the person is doing to know which jobs are risky in the organizations, and the accidents are possible in which types of the job, and of course the deficiency steps can be taken to remove the probable accidents. Why? Because as we discussed in the job analysis, job description is decided here. What we discussed here, job description is decided by the HR manager, and job specification all is decided by the HR manager. That which types of work the person has to do, what is the duties of that work, and what are the responsibilities, and in which types of condition, working condition, in which type of working condition the person has to perform the functions. Here, so with the help of this data, the person, the HR manager, is able to identify the risk which is attached with the performance of any duty. And if the risk is found out by the HR manager, so of course the remedial measures to avoid the probable accident can be taken. Here, so this will be very very helpful you can say avoid the probable accident in your organization if you have done the job analysis. With the help of job analysis, the risk factor which is attached with the process is able to find out. The next is reduction in fatigue. Of course, here this is going to done that removal, but just we discussed that the removal of unnecessary motions can be saved the energy of the person and can save the time in the process of any work. Here, of course, because of this, it will be going to reduce the fatigue time of the worker, the unnecessary time of the worker, and ultimately that time and that energy can be used in some other work. For optimizing use of the worker will be possible because of the job analysis. Why? Because unnecessary motion is reduced. Now the saved energy and the saved time can be used in some other production process or in some other processes. So optimum use of the human resource is possible with the help of job analysis. The next one is useful in evaluations. Which type of evaluation here? So from the job analysis, the person can know whether the particular job is simple one or difficult one or the risky one. As we just discussed that with the help of job analysis, in the job analysis we have discussed about the job description. So with the help of the data of job description, the person, the HR manager, is able to find out that whether the job is simple one or the difficult one or the risky one, and which types of responsibilities it involved, or whether it involved any risky responsibility. If yes, then how much, and for performance of this types of job, this types of qualities, or you can say the physical power also and the intellectual power also required. So this the answer of this all the question is able to find out with the help of the job analysis. So such information is useful in evaluating a particular job. If you want to do the evaluation of a particular job, that whether it is risky one or whether it is simple one, which types of physical power is required, which types of intellectual power is required. So answer of this all the question is made with the help of the job analysis. So the evaluation of a particular job is possible with the help of the job analysis. The next is the helpful in designing the equitable wage structure. Equitable wage structure, why? Because the job analysis helps in the job evaluation, just we discussed in the point number 7. And on the basis of the job evaluation, the person can design the equitable and the rational job wage structure for a different types of posts or for a different types of wages or for a different types of jobs. Suppose for a simple job, the wage structure must be low. For a risky job, the wage structure must be high. Clear, the wage level must be high. And according to the evaluation which is done by the person, the wage structure is going to be decided. Clear, suppose any particular job is require less physical work or less intellectual capacity. So for that, of course, the wage structure will be low. Clear, the wage level will be low. But if any job require the more physical power or it may require the more intellectual qualities, so in that type of job the wage structure must be high. So if the person is planning about the wage structure, so before that the person has to do the job evaluation, and the job evaluation can be done with the help of the job analysis. The next is about the career counseling. Yes, of course, we can do the career counseling of our employees working in the organization. We can give the advice, proper advice to them that for what type of job he is more suitable in the organization. And after doing the career counseling of that employee, we can use optimum, we can use them in an optimum manner. Why? Because we have guided them that for what types of job, for what type of purpose he is better in the organization, for which types of responsibility he can perform in a better way. So this type of career counseling is also possible if you know the skills of the person, if you know the requirement of the job. The next one is about the helpful in human resource planning. In human resource planning, that the person has to make the decisions regarding the how many and what types of the personal skills will be needed during a specific future period of time. And of course, the career path also be decided with the help of the job analysis, and job analysis will be useful in making such of the decision which will be ultimately helpful in the human resource planning. The next one is all about the control over the employees. From the job analysis, the person can find out that how much of the work should be done by the workers per day. And if you know that how much the work the person has to do, so that the person of the HR manager is able to exercise the control over the work done by the worker per day. If he is not able to identify, or if he is not able to define that what type of work the person has to do daily and what quantum of the work the person has to do, so he is not able to control over the employee. So ultimately, if the manager wants to control over the employee, so he must do the job analysis. And after doing the job analysis, he is able to put the control over the work of the employees. The next one is about the increase in the efficiency. Of course, yes, as we discussed that you are going to remove the unnecessary path, unnecessary motion from the work of the organizations. Ultimately, the efficiency and the energy level is going to be saved. The time is going to be saved. You can do the better career counseling of the employees. You can appoint the right person at the right job. So ultimately, the efficiency of the workers who are working in the organization is going to be increased. It may be directly or maybe indirectly, but ultimately the efficiency of the person is going to be increased. And the last one for the day is special employment planning. Here, if you have done the job analysis, means what type of functions the person has to be done and which sets of quality is required, these all things are decided in the mind or on the paper. So you can do the planning for a special types of employees like handicapped one or physically not well. Here, so you want to do a special planning for a special employee. So you are able to do as a manager with the help of the job analysis method. I hope it is done for today. I hope it is understood that why, because it is very, very easy if you know the meaning of the job analysis in a better way. So you are able to explain this all the topics by your own also. Just try to make the meaning of the job analysis very clear, and ultimately this topic will be very, very easy for you. From the next lecture, we are going to start with a new topic. Till then, start learning. Stay home, stay safe. Have a good day. Thank you.